What it do, man? It's your boy Battle Truth coming to you live and direct from the Battle Truth headquarters. Yeah, so I've been telling y'all I'm going to be leading this battle rap media when it comes to this Verb versus Mook. Well, I'm just breaking down Mook because of this. Because it seems like ever since this battle been announced, people been trying to break down Verb. Always trying to say how he washed up, he ain't nothing, they don't want it to happen. Well, you can't change it. It's already here. It's already there. But I hate when people lie and twist things up just to justify their real ulterior motive when it comes to this situation. Now, when you look at Mook and Verb, and let's say none of us knew them. Say you didn't know Verb, say you didn't know Mook. And all we got to go off of what we see. The footage that they got out here. There is no way you can honestly say with an honest, open heart and mind about the situation that Mook is going to beat Verb by what we see they have out here. Mook, for the most part, his name is bigger than him as a battle rapper. Let's just keep it real. A person's name can be greater than the person himself. And Mook is a prime example of that situation. Because when you look at Mook's resume, who owned it? He only really got three notable people on his resume that we might can respect as being legitimate, solid battle rappers. Lux, Sirius Jones, and Iron Solomon. Who else on that resume? Who else is on that resume? You gonna compare that resume to Verb? Are we really going to pay, are we really gonna take that resume and compare it with A-Verb's resume? You can't. He lose on that factor. What about his bars? What about his bars? He only got four battles where he actually really was spitting some stuff that make you say, okay. But those just average bars when you go and listen to that stuff. Verb battle against SB still beat anything Murder Mook ever done. And that wasn't even his best rounds. But what he did to SB was better than anything Murder Mook ever spit. We ain't gonna even add in equation of what he did to Cortez, what he did to Mav Hoffa, what he did to Goods, what he did to Hitman Holla. We ain't gonna add in equation what he did to Arsenal. We ain't gonna add in equation what he did to Hollow the Don. We not gonna add in equation what he did to Tsunami Surf. Come on, man. So that's what I don't like. So when I'm hearing people in the battle rap community saying, oh, Mook gonna kill Verb. Going off what? What are you going off of? You got to be going off of either your friendship with him or Jeff, you just don't like Verb. Because if you going by the fact that's out here, he lose in every category. He lose in every category. Oh, I'm gonna touch and address on that also. I haven't seen Mook done nothing that surprised me to have me thinking like he actually have a chance in this battle at all. At all. And you can't go by the fact of saying, well, Verb been falling off. How you fall off if you winning every year? How do you fall off if you winning every year? And if you a consistent, active person in battle rap, you gonna take losses. That's a fact. It don't matter who you is. If you continue to be active in battle rap, you're going to take losses. You're going to take losses, especially when you're going up against the best. Especially when you're going up against the best or you're a name like Verb where people who getting a shot at you want to take advantage of it and come with the best they ever done. So you can't say that and be honest about yourself with what you're saying. Another thing. Let's just keep it real. This brother got like 40-something battles. Like 40-something battles. And won like 30-something of them. He got one of the best battle rap resumes in battle rap with prominent, notable people respected in the battle rap game. Game. You can't name me three battle rappers with those many battles. You can't name me three battle rappers who got a better resume than Verb, considering the level of competition he went up against. Success rate. Let's just be honest. I'm keeping it real with you. You can't. So you lose that argument also. You lose that argument also. It seemed like for the most part, like I said, Murder Mook is just hype, man. And it seemed like, look, I know battle rappers who definitely know the truth about him, that from the East Coast, and really like Sway Sever, let it be known that he ain't a good like that, that he just hype. Matha, let it be known that it's the same thing. Surf, honestly, could let it be known the same way also. Man, everybody in battle rap for the most part know. We're not expecting for them to admit it, because when it comes to choosing Mook over Verb, we definitely see where they leaning towards. But I bet they ain't going to put no money on it. I bet they ain't going to put no money on it. Especially knowing what's at stake. He dead, man. He don't stand a chance. I'm calling it from the beginning. And I'm going on record saying it. I'm calling it from the beginning. I'm going on record saying it. This dude ain't nothing but hype. I don't think he can compare with anybody that's considered a contender in this era of battle rap. That dude don't got angles. That dude ain't got back to back punching. But he don't come like that. He gonna tell some long drawn out stories. Man, get up out of here. Yeah, his stage performance ain't that good. His voice ain't that good. Yeah, I'm telling you the real. I'm gonna give you the real Mook that people don't want to address. See, he ain't my friend. He ain't my buddy. Neither one of them is. I'm going to tell you what's wrong with both of them. But if I got to choose and pick, I know Verb going to win. And this not a Midwest thing. This just going by the game tapes. What we got out here that we know. And if we going by what we got out here, he don't compare in no type of way. Like I said, if you didn't know Verb, if you didn't know Mook, and we watching the game tape of what these brothers do, there's no way you're going to choose Mook over Verb. In no type of way. In no category. None at all. He hype. That's all it is hype. Hype and friendships. Hype, friendships, and respect. That's the three things he got going in his favor. The hype of his name and his return, because people ain't seen him in a while. Friendship based upon the people who built friendships and relations with him. Let's keep it real. Get up out of here, man. That's all that is. Hype and friendship, man. That's it. And where he from. And where he from. That's it. If he wasn't from New York, they'd be all going for Verb. They'll be all going for Verb. But since he from New York, Harlem, they gonna make it an argument. Like I said, where he from, his respect, and it's all just hype. He lose this battle easily. This ain't finna be hard. This ain't finna be hard at all. And I like it's on the RBE platform. None of that URL hype and gassed up the where it take place in Harlem. Where he from. Like, get up out of here. Stop it. Real talk, man. We gonna make sure that this stuff be done fair, man. Where it need to be. You know what I'm saying? I don't see what the hype is about. I can't do that. I ain't finna just give a man credit who don't deserve it, who ain't earned it. This brother ain't been active. He ain't did nothing. And you know what's crazy about him not being active? This dude ain't even that old like that. Come on, what makes him different than anybody else? So Sway, Sever, Head, Ice, Verb, them all could be active, but this dude ain't active like he actually an old man or something. Get up out of here, man. He choosing not to be active. He don't want none of that smoke. The only reason why he thinks he got a chance against Verb is because he figured that Verb ain't as good as he used to be back then. That sound dumb as hell, man. Look, it depends on who you going up against. It depends on who you going up against. He definitely going to be prepared for you. So when people be like, oh, we want to see the Verb who went against such and such. Look at who he went against when he put it on. His pen was pushed. He was motivated. It depends on who it is. That does matters a whole lot. You know what I'm saying? I hate to say it, but it's a fact. Certain names going to move you, going to push you to take it to another notch. Certain other people be like, oh, well, I'm just going to go light. Yeah, I'm just keeping it real. You don't forget how great you is because you was that way. This ain't like basketball and sports where it's somebody who's running faster than you now because you used to run fast back in the day, or you can't dunk as good as you used to do when you were younger, so now you're shooting fadeaway jumpers. This rap music, fam. This rap music. As you get older, your mind should become more advanced. You become more creative. You get what I'm saying? So this ain't sports. This rap music, man. Putting words together, man, being and by him being in it so long like he do, he should be more creative in how he structure his rounds and stuff. Mook don't know how this is, man. That brother gonna come here just like Cassidy did, looking horrible. Looking horrible. When Cassidy returned, he looked horrible and tried to throw the battle off and mess up the venue. Now it had to get thrown in the garage to suit him. Same thing with Mook. When he returned back from Summer Madness, he looked it horrible, man. He looked it horrible on that stage. No performance. Horrible, man. Get up out of here. Ain't nobody watching that. When he returned for Lux, looked it horrible on that cage, whatever they was in on Total Slaughter. Man, that was lame. That was weak. I'm not impressed. I ain't seen nothing. Nothing. So I'm just keeping it real. Why everybody trying to hate on this man, give him credit, man. Give him credit. At least he been in the game. At least he continued to be active 10 years straight, ain't took a day off. You want to sit here and praise a man who just coming to capitalize off everybody else's work, making it seem like he was a part of it and he the reason behind it, and he not. He not the reason behind nothing that's going on in battle rap right now. But this is what they laying out. You know what I'm saying? This is what he tried to lay out just so he can come get a check. Like he helped build this. He didn't do this. He didn't build this, man, at all. Let's just keep it real. He was on some DVD tapes. He didn't build this stage. He did not build this URL stage. Period. Let's keep it real. It didn't even exist. It didn't even exist when he was rapping. That's real facts for you. They don't want to talk about that, though. So all the brothers who putting in all this hard work, all the brothers who active every year, year after year after year after year, battering, bruising themselves, taking hits and in battle rap community, keeping it afloat, keeping the fan base and come. These people ain't here for Mook. He didn't build the culture. He didn't build the stage. But yeah, he want to capitalize a big check off of it like he the one that actually built it. Come on, man. Let's be real. If brothers going to be real, if God's going to be real, am I lying? Somebody challenged me on me lying about this. He didn't build the fan base. He didn't build the platform. He had nothing to do with the success of the URL. And where battle rap is at right now, nothing at all. But want to come in and collect the check because like he actually the one who laid the groundwork for it. Man, get up out of here. Stop lying, man. That ain't true. That ain't true at all. It's not true at all. Rex got a better argument than him any day. Come on now. So that ain't true. So when you talk about what's going on, I'm going to give credit to the brothers that have been here, who ain't took a day off, who put in all that work. And Bird definitely one of those guys, whether you want to respect him or not. He did a lot for battle rap. Sometimes he arrogant, sometimes he cocky, sometimes he say some stupid things, but he ain't no guilty to anybody else. If you listen to a battle rap talk, they all cocky, arrogant, and say some stupid stuff for the most part. But you still can't weigh out the equation of what this brother done and gave to battle rap, brother. So that's why I'm in his corner on this situation. I'm not finna let people slander this dude like he's some lame, washed up dude when he still got the best footage out here. He still got the best footage out here. Put that to the test, Rome. Put that to the test. Put New Jersey twerk bars up against Verb bars. Put that to the test. And I believe Verb beat him. I'm keeping it real. But I'm just saying that just to put that out there. It's really no big deal. But since he one of the rising stars and they pushing him, let's just keep it real. Verb to this day still got the best footage in battle rap, period. You ain't gonna never find no round that was better than that Cortez first round. Level 3 Showtime, when Showtime was on fire, that was crazy. You ain't gonna get nobody to ever outdo that round. Yo, what's happening, Meow? Let the window half down, down. Yo, what's happening, Meow? Cook out the camel, U-turn. I got a double back like a camel. Click out of ammo, Randall. Riding ham, cutting ham like Randall. Man, that dude be lighting them cats up, man. Let's keep it real. This dude got quotables after quotables after quotables after quotables. And on every level, the dude is just crazy. You die. You dead, man. The dude got the best jokes, the best personals, the best quotables, best real talk. Like, come on, man. Let's keep it real. Let's keep it real, man. This dude dead. Why people don't like to tell the truth? They can say I'm hating all they want to, but let me ask you one thing. Am I lying? Keep it real, y'all. Am I lying? Maybe you like Mook, you worship him, but let's keep it real. Am I lying, though? Am I lying? Look at his resume. Look at the footage he got out here. There's no way you can say, like I said, if we didn't know him, neither one of them. You never heard of Verb. You never heard of Mook. We watched their battles. There's no way you pick Mook over this dude. No way. It's easy. It ain't even something to guess or think about. Like, oh, no, man. I think. No. You're going to be like, ooh, dude, to kill him. Mook knew that. Come on, man. Let's stop playing, man. So I'm just killing the hype. That ain't going to save you. August 18th, the hype ain't going to save you. Your name not going to save you. Where you from ain't going to save you. You better come with it. You better have something. I want to make you so mad, brother, that even though you said your rounds are finished already, this brother said his rounds finished already and the battle ain't even been announced. But your rounds finished already. Come on, man. Stop playing. Stop playing. I guess it is. If you get 4 or 5 years to write, man, get up out of here. That still ain't gonna help you. That's how I know you even more dead. 4 or 5 years of old-fashioned battle rap. This is a whole nother level. So you right. You right. That's how I know you dead. But with that being said, August 18th, nobody gonna be able to help you. I hope I make you so mad, you go back and you write fair. You write all over again and you write fair. You throw away all them years of built up bars you done got that Funk Flex didn't want to hear. And you honestly write like every other battle rapper do who just getting the word of an opponent. That you actually really faithfully write 3 months in advance. Like I told you, when you giving Lux and Mook time like that, they not so good. Then I call it in that Arsenal battle. I say, yeah, Lux fire when he got a year or two off. Yeah, he fired. All them built up bars. Acting like they don't be, oh, I don't be watching battle rap. Oh, I ain't in today. Yes, y'all is. You be right there with that pen and pad writing. Knowing who you want to take and wait for you to get that call. We definitely know that. We definitely know that. But you know what? Y'all not so good when you got 3 months prep. See, this the era they not used to. In they era when they was rapping, of course they was ready. They all saying the same raps. You saying the same 12 raps everywhere you go. You said it in Philly, then you said it in New Jersey, then you said it in Harlem, then you went to say it at the Bronx, then you went to say it at the Queens. Man, please, the band flip. I heard that, I'm about to kill him. He said that on the radio. On Casa versus T-Rex. The band whip. Brother said the same raps like I wasn't in Queens, like I wasn't in the Bronx, like I wasn't in Harlem. Like, man, this dude using the same raps. Please, this battle truth. It ain't my judgment that's in question. It's yours. You got saved, brother.